Hello, investors. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Michael from Deep Value Returns on Seeking Alpha. Today, I want to talk about Fulgent. So Fulgent is at the epicenter of the COVID world, right? So are we going to go through, we're going to unpick what parts you need to think about as the underlying business going forward and what parts are COVID related. Unlike other analysts, I do believe that the COVID side of the business does still carry some value, and I'm going to try and unpick what that value could be. And then we're going to talk about the underlying business and think about, to a certain extent, what the profit margins could be for COVID for Fulgent as a whole. So as you can see here in the graph, Q4 2021 is pointing towards negative 36% year-over-year growth rates. Okay, so as I already alluded to, there is the COVID business and there is the core business. Within the core business, you can see the red arrows there. There's a portion which is COVID-related, next generation sequencing, NGS, next generation sequencing, COVID revenues, okay? So that's inside the core business, okay? Now, as I already described, 83% of the business for Q4 21 is pointing towards, is the core COVID business, okay? 17% is the core business. So when you look at Fulgent as a whole, only 17% is what's going to go forward after COVID is gone, okay? Within that 17%, next generation sequencing also makes up 17%. So the core business here, 83%, comes down to Fulgent's partnerships, okay? So this is Fulgent's, the core business, it's partnerships that they've got with CSI, it's the joint venture with China. So that's what you need to think about, right? Now, this is what I want to highlight, okay? So the total core revenue was 40 million for the last quarter, okay? And management talks about excluding COVID and next generation sequencing, the business was up 160% year over year. So it's clearly growing at a very rapid rate, and that's what you need to think about. This underlying business is growing at a reasonably rapid rate of 160% year over year, okay? Now, let's make some assumptions. Let's make the assumption that going into next year, the core business, excluding COVID, decelerates meaningfully and grows only somewhere between 50 and 80% year-over-year compounded annual growth rate. So at the midpoint, let's say that that business grows by 75% year-over-year, okay? So what you're left with there is 238 million in revenues. Okay, that's what I want you to think about. 238 million revenues for the core business growing at 75% year over year. Okay, now just let me take a step back. Remind everyone, 41% of the market cap is made up of cash. They have, as of at the end of December, they'll have 1 billion of cash and cash equivalents. Okay, so let's unpick this. So Fulgent doesn't really give you much of a sense of the profit margins of the core business. It's very difficult to get a sense here what the core margins will be. This is what we do know, okay? We know that as the revenues from the core COVID business grow rapidly, the margins expand meaningfully, okay? But let's just, for simplicity, look at the 1 billion of cash equivalents on the balance sheet, take that away, you're left with 1.5 billion for the market cap, okay? Now, as I already described before, 238 million is the core business that is going to be growing at somewhere, I estimate, probably around 75% year over year. So investors are paying slightly over 6x forward sales for that side of the business, okay? But now let's make some assumptions here, okay? Let's say that the COVID, this is the bulk of the business, decelerates meaningfully in 2022 by 60% year over year. That implies that you get 252 million in revenues, okay? So the 252 million revenues, right now it's very high margins. You can see here 72% operating margin. But as the revenues contract, that means that the operating margins compress. So let's make the assumption that it compresses to approximately 40%. Now, remember, right now it's 72%, but right after the COVID started in Q2 2020, it was 15%. So I'm saying somewhere in between that. So they've got some efficiencies ironed out, but they're not operating at the scale. So they haven't got that economy of scale. So they can't really grow the operating margins as strongly. But anyway, you're left with approximately 40% operating margin on the 252 million revenues. So I've asserted a 1x multiple to that side of the business because it is compressing, but there is still some staying power, particularly if you think about Omnicore, Omnicom, and if you think about other variants that could come up, Delta, you know, other variants that could come up as well, so that you give one times forward sale for that side of the business. So then you're left with here. Here's the math, right? Market cap right now is 2.5 billion. Subtract 1 billion from the balance sheet of cash, you end up with 1.5 billion of adjusted market cap. 1.5 billion. You look at the COVID side of the business of 252 million, and you assert a 1x multiple to that. You're left with 1.3 billion of adjusted market cap. That implies that investors are paying less than 6x forward sales for the core next generation sequencing business, excluding any COVID at all, excluding the COVID next generation sequencing and excluding the whole of the COVID operation that Fulgen grows. So assuming that the core business, the next generation sequencing core business, grows by 75% year over year, you're paying less than 6x sales for that. Now it's difficult obviously to get some sense of what the operating margins will be from the core business. They don't give you that granularity, and they could do, and I don't know why they choose not to, but if they did, they probably would get a much higher multiple on the stock than they do right now. But in any case, if you remember, the management team here owns 31% of the stock. So the founder has 600 million worth of equity on the line right now, okay? And if you think about it, he was able to not found the business in the 90s. He also founded this business, the Fulgen, in 2011. Also, he was able to recognize the opportunity that COVID would give to his business and pivot the business over to predominantly face COVID. And obviously, COVID will dwindle at some point, but this put Fulgen on the map. Now, think about it this way. This type of founder and CEO that is able to to pivot the business so dramatically, and you give that person 1 billion in cash, they're more likely than not to find something that positively drives shareholder value higher. Because after all, he has 600 million worth of stock of ownership here. So in any case, hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to check out Marketplace called Deep Value Returns. And okay, yeah, thanks for listening. Bye.